In this video, we're going to show you how to color code your Google Forms quizzes in order to make yourself an easily readable data heat map. Welcome to Mr. Cook's Corner.
As you can see here, we have a sample quiz with just 5 questions. I put a couple different types in there. We've got some multiple choice, we've got some short answers, and we've got some true or false as well. As with all of the quizzes that I create, I have an answer key set up for each one. That way you can self-grade, but this is not a requirement. And here's the response form that you have once a quiz has been filled out. In this case, I had it filled out 11 times. And you can see the scores. However, it's really not easy to tell who missed what and how many they missed. We want to make this visually appealing and easy to interpret for the teacher. The way we do this is through conditional formatting. It's under the Format tab, and it's really easy to set up once you learn how to do it. Let's give it a try. On the menu bar, you're going to click on Format, and it's going to be right here towards the bottom. But first, we have to highlight what we want to change. You don't want to click on individual cells. That's only going to make a format for those specific ones. What you want to do is you want to highlight an entire column. So click on the column, then go to Format and click on Conditional Formatting. Once you click on that, you'll see the Conditional Formatting box pop up on the right-hand side. We've given it a range by clicking on the C column, and now we're ready to apply the rule. As you can see back here on the quiz, the question was, what is the 9th letter of the alphabet? And the correct answer was I. So all we want to do is set a rule to say highlight it when the answer isn't I. You'll notice that there are many rules to choose from in the dropdown. In this particular case, you're just going to choose text does not contain. And when we put in the correct answer, I, you'll notice that everything that isn't I has been highlighted. Those are wrong answers. Now we notice that they're green, and usually when we have a wrong answer, we want it a different color. So all you have to do is go to the formatting style, click the paint can, and choose a color that you want. I usually go with a red. You'll notice that the entire column below it is also red. That's because the cells there do not contain I. If this is okay with you, you can leave it as is. If it bugs you, you can add another step to make that go away. The easiest way to go about doing that is to start out with a simple rule of choosing is empty, and then choosing white. And then when you hit done, it's going to clear out anything that's empty with no color. Then you just do add a rule and do what we did before. Now you have it formatted to where the cells below it are not shaded in. If you'd like correct answers to show up in a different color, simply add another rule. This time you're going to choose format cells if text is exactly, and then put in the answer. In this case, it was capital I. Choose the color that you want. Hit done. And now you can see you've got correct and incorrect answers. For questions with number answers, the process is pretty much the same. You highlight the column by clicking on the letter, click on format, conditional formatting, and we're going to go through the same process. The first one, format if the cell is empty, give it a white color, hit done. Now we'll add the second rule, format the cells if the text does not contain the answer. In this case, the answer was 12, and make it red or whatever color you choose. You can see we now have 2 rules. And now we'll add a third rule. Add the rule, format the cells if the text is exactly, put the correct answer, choose your color, and hit done. So when one of the questions has a longer answer, what we want to do ahead of time is just highlight and copy the text. Now we can go in, click our column, add the rule, choose format cells if it does not contain, and this time we're just going to paste the answer, change our color, and hit done. You may notice that when you're done that some of the question titles are highlighted as well because they fall under some of the rules. If you don't like that, all you have to do is click back into your rules and just take out the first column. So in this case you'll see G1. You would just click in the red box and change it from G1 to G2, and it makes it go away. The cool thing about Google Forms and their quizzes is that as they submit them, it populates live on the answer document. So as you can see here, I only have 11 responses, but if I were to fill out this quiz, the second that I hit submit, you'll notice it automatically populates with the formatting in place. One cool last thing that you might notice is that with Google Forms quizzes, you can set them to self-grade. In this case, I've already set my answer key and it's showing me the score. If you want to set your final scores to certain colors, you can do that as well. If someone got less than or equal to 3 correct, I want to make that red. If someone got equal to just a -1 and they got 4 out of 5 right, I'm going to set that to yellow. And finally, if someone got all of them correct, go down to is equal to and click 5 for 5 out of 5. Give it that green and hit done. And now you can see their overall score on a color scale.
We got lots more where that came from. Why don't you go ahead and start with one of these two videos you see on the screen right now. In the meantime, if you have an idea for a video, let us know. MrCooksCorner.com. See you next time.